You guys believe in
like some
aliens?
Sort of intelligent life out there up in the sky, like watching us or somehow try to controlling us?
Pretty sure you already have heard about them, but not really sure how much you believe in it, like how much you've been thinking before about this sort of intelligent creatures, which some people believe they exist up in the sky somewhere, watching us, controlling us.
Me personally, very agnostic in that I got no clue where they exist or not. However, I would like to believe that there are like some sort of life out there. They have like some sort of superpowers and they're trying to control us. Specifically, when you see there are like so many idiots these days around. It's not a bad idea to believe there are like some sort of creatures and they're controlling these sort of people. So basically, whatever these people doing, as long as you believe there are like some sort of aliens out there, you can blame it on the aliens. So basically, it's not the humans' fault, it's the aliens' fault. They are in charge, they are controlling these people. Not really sure actually is correct methodology to blame some people because of the things that they're doing. But based on my personal experience, specifically like living in Sweden like 6 years, I've seen like there are like so many like people they don't know how to treat. For example, I had a kind of quarrelsome with a girl last week in Pop Anchor, saying like, you're one of those posh chick, I barely see you in Anchor, it's good to see you over here, what brought you here? Apparently, the word posh and the fact that I brought it up that I was not expecting you to be in Pop Anchor didn't make her very happy and satisfied with the thing that I said. So basically the whole night she was trying to come and talk and like try to be a bit aggressive against me. The funny part though was her mates. Specifically there was a guy came to me and said like, oh, you made my mate very sad, so you have a very small dick and you're a faggot. So you see, that's how people express themselves. They're not happy with the way that you behave, you got a small dick, and
pretty
you're
sure all of you have similar experiences dealing with some people. And as I said, when you see this level of stupidity, when you see like mature people, they still do not know how to behave, they still do not know how to express themselves,
then you start realizing it's not a very bad idea to believe in some sort of aliens or like out of space kind of creatures controlling these people. So you still gonna love the humans, you still gonna control your anger, you cannot hate these people, you blame everything on the aliens. So they are in charge, basically they're controlling these people, as I said before.
The reason however I started talking about aliens wasn't actually about the thing happened to me at Pop Anchor last week. The reason actually I would like to talk about aliens at the very first point is I've noticed that aliens now like recently became very popular on music industry. So many pieces of art, so many artists, music and topics, articles focus on aliens. I've noticed,
for example, I was reading this article on Crank magazine Facebook page. The author of the article was trying to focus on 11 most popular or maybe most important music about aliens. I found it quite interesting, specifically some of the example that he explained and like went a bit deep inside that music. It was kind of interesting. I chose however only three of them, which I'm gonna discuss with you guys.
Right then, the first one is a song by Blink-182 called Aliens Exist. So not really sure how much you guys know about these people, but they kind of like punk rock, like emo punk rock, childish punk rock, teenage punk rock, something like that. So if you remember what I said at the very beginning, when you would like to believe in something that you got no like 100%
logical clue about the existence, but you want that things to be there. That's sort of like a childish and irresponsible kind of choice that you make because you would like that things to happen. You can see the relationship, I believe, between like this song and what I said at the very beginning. Hey mom, there's something in the back room. Hope it's not the creatures from the above. You used to read me stories as if my dreams were boring. We all know conspiracies are dumb. So you see, this is very like teenage kind of lyrics, and you can see how irresponsible these people are since they see themselves as still as a teenager.
Creatures from above. You used to read me stories as if my dreams were boring. We all know conspiracies are dumb.
So yeah, that's a cool song actually. I like Blink 182, the punk rock irresponsible people. Alright, let's move on. The second one is one of my fav sort of music. It's called Starlight by the Fabulous Muse, the English awesome Muse. In this song, actually, Matt Blame and the Muse members are chasing Starlight. They say like, "Now I'll never let you go if you promise not to fade away. Never fade away." And then it said, "Our hopes and expectations, black holes and revelations. Our hopes and expectations, black holes and revelation." Again, I'm hoping that you can see the relation between the disappointment that Muse has in this song. At least I believe that. That's how I see it. With the thing that I said at the very beginning, when you're disappointed with the human, when you're disappointed with the life, yeah, then you chase a light because you would like to chase a light, even though there is no light, but you're chasing it. In this song, I think, since at the very first point, actually, I was listening to this song, I had that sort of feeling like Muse and the Matt Blame is not really happy with life, and he's looking and seeking some sort of solutions, some sort of alternatives. That's why they're really like interested in the things happen in this space, chasing in the starlight and believing alien. If you promise not to.
Bellissimo.
All right, let's move on. The last song is a song by Misfits, the band I really like and I really respect and appreciate what they did in the past years ago. The song is called "I Turned Into a Mushroom." So at the very beginning of the song said, "Position of the mind is a terrible thing. It's a transformation with an urge to kill. Not the body of a man from earth, not the face of the one you love. Cause, well, I turned into a Martian, woo-hoo-hoo. I can't even recall my name, woo-hoo-hoo. Times I never hardly sleep at night, woo-hoo-hoo. Well, I turned into a Martian today." Again, you can see some sort of sigh of disappointment and nihilism, I would say, of the life. So as long as you're not happy somehow with the life, you turn to be a Martian. And these people turn into a Martian just today. Alright lads, that was for today.
at the very first part of the show. I'm pretty sure you got so many things to say, so please share. Let me know what you think about aliens and these songs. Of course, I'm going to share the link of the article so you can have a look in your own time. There are like so many bands over there. Saxon, Marilyn Manson, Rob Zombie there. There are like so many others, like examples. So you can just go through it and share your opinions with me. All right, let's move on and let's see what's happening in Stockholm this weekend.
Right then,
I've chosen three cool events actually for the weekend. Pretty sure there are like so many other things happening, but these are my faves. The first one actually, it's a gig taking place in Fryshuset in Stockholm. They're gonna be live performance by a Finnish heavy metal band called Beast in Black. The ticket gonna be around 300 Swedish crowns. These people gonna start at around 7 p.m. till 11. They said like they're influenced by Judas Priest, Manowar, Wasp, Accept, and of course Black Sabbath. So they look interesting. Never heard about them before, but hopefully you're gonna be there. And on the next video, I'm gonna share some of the videos I'm gonna be recording, so you would get that sort of idea what happened at the gig. Alright then, Harry B. James gonna have something fun this weekend. It's at like Club X9 presents by Proud. I'm translating in English. Scumbag Millionaire gonna be there live. You're gonna be 18. It's gonna be free entry event until 9 o'clock p.m. of course, but you expect it to pay 80 crowns after that. And there are gonna be some DJs playing, and during the midnight, Scumbag Millionaire are gonna be on stage. There are like so many people said they're gonna be there. It looks cool. Harry B. James, actually, I love the people who works over there and like run these events. They mostly come across with the really good stuff. So I do recommend that you go to that place. I mean, Stockholm has like three or four cool rock bars. Pop Anchor, of course, one of the best. Harry B. James, it's really cool, specifically in terms of events. And Copperfields. So these are the most important and popular places in Stockholm. The last event I would like to talk about, it's the one taking place in Copperfield on Saturday, the 30th of March. There are going to be like three bands. The last band actually going to be playing is called Mr. Misery. And I've noticed that like so many people really like them. Got no clue who these people are. I would try to listen to some of the stuff before I go there. But what I can be sure is I'm definitely going to be there. There are going to be two other bands. Grav Stenot, something like that. I hope I'm like pronouncing correct. Got no clue what does it mean. They're going to be there. Also, there's another band called Van Helga. They say like the kind of like a classic black metal. I got no clue either about these people, but based on my experience, I believe like these people who are gonna play on Copperfield, they're gonna be good. So most probably on Saturday Eve, I'm gonna be there, and I'm trying to like have a quick chat with these people, take some photos and some videos, so you people would know what happened during this event on Saturday night. That was it. As I said, I'm pretty sure there are like so many other events taking place this weekend, so let me know if something fun's happening. And let me know about your opinion about the whole program. So hopefully in future we can communicate more and we can improve the content and the news and everything about this program. But till then, you guys take care.